Recharge. Don't know what episode, and I don't remember the usual intro I usually say after good morning.
Well,
so what
it's the second one that we've done since we started in the 50s, so it's 54. Just simple counting.
You think I... All right, yeah. You're probably right. What do I know?
I'm not probably right. I am right.
That's real cocky for coming. Anyway. So, gaming stuff. What do we got?
NX. The gift that just keeps on giving. Nintendo just announced this thing. Just please. I just want to know.
At this point, we basically know everything about it.
At this point, we know. And especially since all these rumors that just came out with dimensions and everything, we have a pretty good idea of what it is. Now, we didn't talk about this last time because, I don't know, I think we just ran out of time because he started ranting about No Man's Sky.
Hey, you said you gave me 10 minutes.
I'll give you 10 minutes. I gave you, like, 10 minutes and then you took, like, 20, so...
I took the 10. I said this is probably going to go for 5 minutes. You were like, just take 10. So I took 10.
You took... We were all way over 10, but that's something else. Okay.
You're full of bullshit.
So, the NX... We know it's going to be a portable console that you can plug into your TV, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's settled. Good.
Which is basically like the GameCube accessory that you'd put onto the bottom of your GameCube, and you could put Game Boy games into it. So you could play Game Boy games on your TV.
Yeah.
It fucking blew my mind.
And that was amazing. I play Mario 3 on that thing all the time, and it was awesome.
I played the fuck out of Pokemon on TV before anyone else. That was a good guess.
Okay, so what this thing's gonna be, it's gonna have a 6.2-inch screen, 720p, so it's gonna have HD. It's okay to do 720p, especially it's gonna be small. 1080p will cost a lot more, so I mean, it's good to just keep it at 720.
I mean, also, what resolution is a 3DS currently?
It's like 340.
Yeah, so I mean.
So it's a good
720
upgrade.
Is okay.
We're going to HD finally.
Yeah.
You can play all your favorite games in HD on your little 6.2-inch screen. It's gonna have detachable controllers. They're gonna have motion controls similar to the Wii. And they're gonna be symmetrical, so they're gonna have the little the sticks on top.
This looks wrong. I'm just gonna go ahead and say that. This looks wrong.
Yeah, the sticks on top. It's gonna have the face buttons under it. On the right side, you're gonna have the A, B, X, Y buttons, as always.
Right.
On the other side,
might I say real quick, why the fuck does Nintendo use A, B, X, Y, but in a different configuration than Xbox?
Nintendo did it first. Xbox is the one that screwed it up.
Sure, but I play a lot more Xbox now than I.
Well, that's your problem.
Right. Think about this. You don't have to say anything, but I want you to press X on a controller.
I didn't say. Never mind. Excuse that.
There are three different places that your finger can go. On the bottom, to the left, or to the top.
On top, uh-huh.
Right, I was thinking it was on the right, it's top.
No, it's always top. It's like those three. If you're doing GameCube, it could also be on that side too. So yeah, you're all over the place.
So yeah, and then, okay, even better. Why the fuck did they change it from GameCube to...
Because the GameCube had a weird thing where it was like, okay. X buttons are bad. Okay, I get it.
I will say I've gone back and played a bit of PlayStation lately. I never finished Infinite, so to finish that, I said press X to jump. So my brain, of course, hits to the left because that's where it all hits Xbox, and so I just end up shooting people with lightning. Like, fuck, I wanted to jump. Yeah, back to the X.
Okay, so it's gonna have that's on the right, and on the left it's gonna have a D-pad. That's gonna be different this time, and it's gonna be individual buttons instead of an actual just D-pad. So it's going to be similar to what the PlayStation 4 has, the PlayStation 4 controller has, where like it has four things, which would make sense if you have a symmetrical controller that you could probably use, pretty much you have two Wii remotes attached to the sides of the screen that you could use for like probably multiplayer or whatever.
Wasn't that also the original tech demo for the Wii U was two Wii remotes put on the edge of the screen?
Yeah.
So literally what they're doing is they're just bringing back their prototype for the Wii U and selling it to us as a new console.
Now what I do like about this is that you could... Since they're going to have motion controls and they're going to have the same type of controls, that means that you can have multiplayer out of the box.
What, because you can...
Because you can literally have two controllers with you already.
Yeah, okay.
So that's neat.
I can kind
of
see it.
The NX is going to have a share button. So you can share to like Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, and all that. Weavers, of course.
Duh.
Yeah.
So it's going to have like social media integration.
Yeah.
All right.
The size of the thing, it's going to be slightly thicker than the new 3DS XL. All
right.
So not that bad. The screen itself, it's going to be about the size of the XL. But once you attach the controllers to the side, it's going to be more towards Wii U gamepad wide size.
Okay.
So you can come that. It's rumored to come out of course, Zelda.
Duh.
It's rumored to have perhaps some Luigi's Mansion on launch. Animal Crossing. Especially in an Animal Crossing game would actually connect to the new Animal Crossing game coming out for iOS and Android.
Oh.
To have some connectivity with that.
All right.
So that's what we know so far. What do you think?
I'm annoyed because I want it, but less than like a year and a half ago, I bought the Wii U finally because Smash Bros.
Yeah.
And all that stuff. And, you know, finally convinced me to get it, and that was a decent $300. Because, all the games included and all that kind of stuff. So, I'm annoyed because I haven't really played through the Wii U library, and I'd like to get a little more use out of that first. But I also know that all the good games are out already, and it's kind of my fault for not playing them yet.
Yeah.
But I still don't really want to, drop another $300 on the NX plus game, whatever. So, I don't know.
I forgot to mention this. It's rumored to have some people saying that it might have 32 gigabytes of onboard storage that can be expandable through SD cards.
Okay.
Now, granted, it's gonna have cartridges and it's gonna have a small port for the TV. So I mean, like, if you want to expand your storage, you have SD cards, or you could use cartridges to play your games and just call it a day.
All right. I don't know. I still kind of feel like I wish I could get more out of my Wii U. It's on me for not getting more of it by now. But I got it so late into its life cycle and all the good stuff was out already. But at least the NX, it's got Zelda at launch. It's gonna have Animal Crossing, which is a really fun series. And I've never been a huge fan of it, but my sister loves it. So I'll end up just sitting on the couch with her while she plays. So I'm probably gonna end up getting that anyway, just kind of as a surprise for her. What else did you say? Oh yeah, Luigi's Mansion.
Luigi's Mansion 3.
Luigi's Mansion would probably be, if nothing else, that would be the one that tips me over the edge to get it. I loved the first one as a kid. I played the shit out of Dark Moon.
Dark Moon was awesome.
And I'm definitely gonna have to get NX just to play the new one.
It could be like 10 times. It could be spooky in HD.
Oh, alright. I don't know. I'm gonna end up getting it eventually, but as far as console purchase for holiday 2017, it's probably not. I'm not gonna get the NX. I'm probably gonna end up getting the Xbox One Neo or
Scorpio.
Sorry.
I mean, I don't think it's worthwhile purchase since you can play the games on your Xbox One.
Yeah, but I'm meaning to upgrade because I have the very first Xbox that came out.
Yeah,
Xbox One. So it's got like 500 gigs of internal storage, which is gone by now. I've had to start deleting games to reinstall new ones.
It's cheaper to buy a hard drive.
Yeah, but I've had two hard drives. They've both broken and took all my save loop. So I'm going to be upgrading to something that has more internal storage. Oh shit, it's raining.
Yeah.
So I'm probably going to end up getting the Scorpio. I would have gotten the 2 terabyte Xbox One S,
but
except that they all sold out in the first like week, so
yeah,
that's kind of gone.
But
for holiday 2017, I'm definitely gonna be getting the Scorpio instead of NX.
I'm getting NX at launch.
Good, then I can play all the games at your place. I can save myself $300.
No, because I'm going to be playing Zelda Endlessly for an entire year, so that's...
It's probably got multiple saves on it, right? Just make one for Dickwad and let me play on that one.
Dickwad, please save us. Dickwad, wake up.
Oh, I didn't do that now where I go.
Don't you remember Dickwad?
That has to be the best. I want to go back and play Ocarina of Time like that. Just give myself Dickwad. And the hero of time, Dickwad.
Yeah.
I'm immature. I'm a 14-year-old at heart, yeah. And you know it.
No, but it's funny. So we already have the rumored Pokemon games and Mario games for the NX. We're hoping for a good library.
Yeah, if all that's at launch, it'll definitely push sales better. Because what did we have at the Wii U launch?
New Super Mario Brothers U, some Wii U, like a lot of ports, so like Batman Arkham City, Assassin's Creed, Call
Watch
of Duty.
Dogs. Wasn't that on that? Well, Wii U?
Yeah, it was, but Watch Dogs came out when?
Was it not launched?
No, it wasn't a launch.
Oh, my bad.
Watch Dogs came out like 2 years after the Wii U came out.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Plus, I remember Watch Dogs came out on most consoles on May, like at the same time Mario Kart 8 came out. But Watch Dogs didn't come out for Wii U until like October that year.
Oh damn.
So, yeah.
But okay, so yeah, that, you know, nothing really like. Maybe if you're really into 2D Mario games, you get New Super Mario Bros.
Yeah. We were promised Pikmin 3 at launch, but it didn't come out at launch. It ended up coming out until like. 9 months later.
Yeah. When was
granted, after the year was over, we had Mario 3D Land, Super Mario 3D World. We got Wind Waker HD.
When was Wind Waker HD?
That was about 11 months after launch.
Okay, so almost
a year.
And then what did we have at 3DS launch?
We got
Steel Divers, Rayman,
Street Fighter.
Oh yeah, there was a Street Fighter.
Yeah.
Which, you know, it was okay.
It wasn't until like 3 or 4 months later where we started getting Star Fox 3D and Ocarina of Time 3D and...
Yeah, which, you know...
3D Land Mario Kart.
But, basically, both the last two major launches for Nintendo consoles have been pretty shit. So, if at launch the NX has Zelda, Mario, Animal Crossing, like all that, it's going to be a good lineup and it'll probably push more people. Because you're going to grab a wider audience, like, oh, well, I want to play the new Animal Crossing game. I'm just going to, you know, get the Wii U or NX and, you know, see what it does.
I feel like Zelda is going to do a lot of that work for them already. Mm-hmm. Since, you know, Zelda is, like, biggest thing that came out of E3 was Zelda.
Yeah. Remember when we all laughed at Nintendo for going to E3 with
just Zelda
one game?
Yeah.
And then... The only thing that anyone talked about for the next, like, 3 months was that one game.
Oh, yeah. No, I it's funny because I remember seeing people like, oh, yeah, if you didn't make it to the line of Zelda when stores open in, like, 5 minutes, you were not going to play Zelda that day.
Yeah, I remember, like, people would wait the entire day just to play Zelda.
Yeah. It's like, damn.
And then there were press people that would just go like, hey, so we'd like to get some footage and talk about your game. Oh, yeah, come on, right in.
Damn you, press!
Not gonna name names, but I know I watch a couple of people that got to do that. Oh,
yeah. Well, but you know, at least the press is gonna give good press to the game anyway.
I mean, the word of mouth of I waited 8 hours in line to play this game, and it was fucking more than worth it. That is already good press for the game.
I waited like 9 hours all day to play 30 minutes of a game.
But. It's gonna be Skyrim. It's Nintendo Skyrim.
Yeah.
So, which, you know, it took them long enough to do it. It's only been like almost 5 years since the actual Skyrim came out.
Well, it's only been 5 years since the last Zelda game.
It's actually been 5 years since Skyrim. When are we gonna see Elder Scrolls 6? I want that now.
I mean, they're in the remaster right now for Skyrim.
Oh yeah, they are. That's not the next one. Like, it's just a remaster.
Yeah.
Plus, there was a. There was a, like, massive mod that just got finished for Skyrim on the PC, which basically adds, like, another 30 hours of story and like actual gameplay and stuff. And it's like, it's all fan made, but it's like, it's actually like a lot of story. I forget the name of the mod. I can probably look it up if I want to. But I mean, that'll, you know, hold people over. Because right now what it is like, you open up Skyrim, you play for like, I don't know, 3 hours, and then you're bored again because you've already done all the cool stuff. So you turn it off and you don't go back for a year. That's what I do at least. But I just want 6. Yeah. I want Elder Scrolls 6 because Elder Scrolls Online was not great.
Yeah. It's us with Bethesda. It's always worth the wait.
I mean, yeah.
Yeah.
Fallout 4 was fantastic. And yeah, so Fallout 4 was fantastic, and then when Skyrim came out, I remember I got it and I stayed up until like 3 or 4 in the morning playing it.
Yeah.
Just nonstop. So I mean, Bethesda, they make great games, and I don't doubt them on that. I just want the next one in the Elder Scrolls series.
Yeah. So I forgot to say, you were talking to me about some Pokemon Go yesterday.
Oh yeah, shit. Okay, so allegedly, it's unofficial, there's no real like actual sources, but data miners have allegedly found traces or hints or whatever about a buddy system or pet or follower system that might be introduced into Pokemon Go. Basically, this was all found in the last update that came out.
Yeah, it's in the code of the game.
It's in the code already. It's just not implemented at all. It's not called anywhere. So, you know, right now it's pretty much a useless base. But what it could suggest is that you can select a Pokemon and you can have it follow you around a la Heart Gold, Soul Silver, and it'll after X amount of kilometers, it'll start generating buddy candies. Now, what buddy candies do is kind of a toss-up. It could be that they work as the candy for your Pokemon to power it up or level it or to evolve it. They could replace Stardust for your Pokemon to be leveled up, or they could do something completely different that no one's even thought about. But it is a good system to implement because then your starters actually mean something.
Yep.
And you could actually start caring about the Pokemon you've been catching, which, funny enough, we were talking about this yesterday off camera. Because right now it's like, oh yeah, I caught this rare Pokemon. Well, to the grinder it goes, so I can level up my better Pokemon at the same time. You know, it's like, there's no point in keeping any.
You're worthless in battle, but you're a wonder. But you're level 500 and you're level 2.
Yeah. So it's like, you kind of end up just grinding everything you find. That's after the first wonder you get.
It's a more sadistic version of the original games.
Yeah. But with a buddy system, you can actually, you know, I can actually level up my, you know, Charmander, which I have not found a single fucking Charmander in the wild after the first one I caught. I've gotten a lot of Bulbasaurs and a lot of Squirtles. Hell, I even hatched a couple of Pikachus, but I have yet to find a goddamn Charmander.
Now, what might also help are the new instances that we're also found in the code.
Oh yeah,
The floral, cool, and spicy instances, which should be able to attract grass, water, and fire Pokemon respectively.
Exactly. So instances are kind of weird right now, where they basically work like a lure on your current location, but they still work off of spawn points. A lot of people that, you know, if you really care about the game, you probably already know all this. If you don't, then, you know, congrats on the free lesson. So what they do is they rely on local spawn points to generate Pokemon that will spawn on top of you. If it can't find any, it kind of freaks out and it'll just pick up whatever it can and give that to you. If what these would do is they would basically limit what it can spawn to a certain type, which could be great because then you can start possibly farming up Charmanders so I could actually get something out of the first fucking starter they gave you in the game, which is fucking worthless right now. I'm pissed. But that would, presumably, it would also eliminate the need for local spawn points because it would be type-based. Mm-hmm. And so if you're out in the middle of the ocean, you know, you probably wouldn't be getting a whole lot of fire types. But if you start up a fire type instance, it might, you know, kind of override the spawn point thing, and they'll
start getting Growlithe and Vulpixes, which I think the fire type instance will be the most useful one, since those are the rarest kind. Because I mean, I think grass and water you could find more.
I think I found more openly. Grass, like grass, water, and bug types are kind of everywhere.
Yeah, I mean, although I'm gonna say, the grass are the most common I've seen. Then water, and then, you know, then fire is like the rarest. So, because I remember, and I have enough Bulbasaur to like evolve one into a Venusaur. No, not Venusaur, Ivysaur.
There you go.
But
I got a Venusaur already. Damn.
But I barely have enough to like. I need one more to evolve my Squirtle into a War Turtle, and just because I went to New York, I think I almost have enough Charmanders to evolve into Charmeleon.
I mean, people that live in New York make me sad because they get all the good shit and they probably don't even play anymore.
I don't know, man. Central Park was full of Pokemon Go players.
That was also in the first like week of launch.
No, it wasn't.
What?
That was like a month after.
Oh well. I think it's only been now like almost 2 months now. So,
I mean, since a devastating 10 million players have left the game, leaving a miserable, miserable 30 million active players right now.
Didn't they hit like 100 million at some point?
Yeah. Near. Well, you know, active, they've reached 100 million downloads.
Right.
But I think the highest they've gone in active players have been like almost 50 million.
Okay. I mean, that's still.
Which is fantastic!
That's
it's not even respectable, it's fantastic.
It's respectable. I mean, that's...
What other game do you have 50 million people playing at the same, like, all the time?
World of Warcraft. Or
50
back
million.
In its heyday. Yeah, World of Warcraft had a lot of people on it.
I would believe 10 million, 15 million, but not 50.
Hey, people that play WoW, give me a number. I don't actually know stats like that.
I'll take a couple of million. I don't think it's that many.
It's respectable. Don't let it go to Niantic's head. They'll just screw us on later updates. Shut the fuck up, you twat.
Okay. Oh, other updates that are there. They're in the code are player versus player battles.
Right, so you can actually fight your friends without having to have them drop one Pokemon into a gym and then, you know, just being like...
Yeah, and if you're on the same team, you cannot really fight each other, so...
Yeah.
You could also...
Well, I mean, you can do it if you power up the gym, but as soon as someone else puts another Pokemon, then your 1v1 is just kind of gone.
Yeah. Well, then trading is also there. New worlds wide trading with
which people
players,
have been asking
which
for
would be fantastic. I don't know if the trading they're alluding to is local trading or...
Global
trading.
Which I feel like it's going to be local at first until they can implement some kind of friend list deal where you're going to have to... Because I don't, unless they do something like the Wonder Trade in, was it Black and White or was it?
X and Y.
X and Y.
Yeah.
Unless they do something like that where you can just toss up a, you know, random Pokemon into the sky and
get. Yeah, but I don't want that.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. Like, it's going to be local or it's going to be that. Unless they implement a friend list.
I mean, you.
Because if you want to trade with your cousin in Mexico, you're not going to, you'd have to be pretty close to each other to do it. It's got to be local. Or then it'll be Wonder Trade where you're not guaranteed to do it with them. Or it'll be a global trade where you have to have a friends list, which they haven't done yet, and then they're going to do that stupid friend code thing that Nintendo always does, and it's going to fucking drive people insane. It's going to be local, is what I'm saying. At least for the first, like, bit.
Yeah.
Maybe in, like, the second or third update after trading's been given to us, they'll, like, do something global.
So in other words, Pokemon Go is getting fixed.
Slowly. Very, very slowly. Eventually, maybe if we see a battle update, that'll be what it does. But, the battle update will be the one that does it for me, because then you can actually, like, you know, gyms will actually make more sense than just spam fest on your phone. Which, hey, surprise, dodging's a thing in the game. It's actually surprisingly useful. Also, totally, it makes you focus on the game. Which, yeah, it's great, but when the rest of the focus is just spam your finger quickly, it's kind of pointless.
See, I find that it's not really worth dodging.
It definitely is.
Like, I've tried dodging, and dodging makes everything worse, because it's slow, so I just rather just tap.
You know, you can avoid a lot of damage if you dodge, and then just get back to the damage. So
yeah, I mean, you could just avoid, like, the big attacks, but that's about it.
You can dodge a lot of stuff.
No, but you've got it.
Hey, surprise, there's a flash on the edge of your screen, a little yellow thing. If you swipe left or right during that, you'd basically negate 90% of the damage you would have taken, no matter what the attack was.
I don't know, but it will just make the battle even longer and more tedious.
I mean...
Battles are already short here.
I I want a decent battle update. Something, implement some kind of move system. Even if it's like, all right, you know, you have 5 seconds to pick a move that you want to use. That'll happen, then the AI in the gym will take care of its move, and then that'll happen, and then, you know, you get your, even it's something like that.
Tackle, fire blast, tackle, fire blast, tackle, fire blast.
Even something like that would be better, in my opinion, over what we have right now, which is pretty shit.
Yep.
Because it's, yeah, it's a mobile game battle system, which, you know, appeals to the lowest common denominator, which is, you know, the people that are used to just tapping on a screen forever to do stuff. But it's not a Pokemon battle system, and that kind of annoys me. All right, by the way, we're going to have to get gas when we go home today.
Oh, great.
But, yeah, it's slowly getting there. It's slowly going to be the game we were promised that we were hoping for at launch. Because if I say promised, then, you know, people are going to bring up No Man's Sky, and that was promised when it really wasn't.
You are the one that just bring up No Man's Sky.
I don't want to waste another 10 minutes. Anyway. Anything else?
That was good. Well, there's a whole, the next Pokemon Go. PlayStation Plus got a price increase, and people are pissed about that, which I don't get why you're so pissed about it.
It's still cheaper than Xbox Live, isn't it?
I think it's about the same now.
Is it really $60 per year?
I think so, yeah. Okay. Somewhere. No, it's actually, it's 10 a month. So it's a little lower, but not by much.
How much is it?
It's like $10 per month.
Then it's like twice the price of Xbox Live Gold.
No, Xbox, because you just say $60 per year, right?
Yeah, that's
so. That's like $12 per month.
No.
Yes.
No. How many months are there in a year?
Five. Wait.
There's 12.
Wait. Oh.
60 divided by 12 is 5. If PSN is,
it's like $10.
Is $10. That's 120 a year. That's twice as much.
Okay, I gotta check the numbers again. But okay, anyways, people are getting too pissed about it. I think it's just stupid that you're so mad about it, because you make impulse buys that are like 10 times more expensive than that without even thinking. So,
I mean, yeah, I think what it really is, it's an increase in the price of something that people have been using for a while. It looks like a cash grab. I'm not saying it is, but it looks like, hey, we have a lot of people on our thing. Let's just up our price a little bit, just enough so that we can get some more money out of them.
Well, yeah, but I mean, from what I hear, like, the service in PSN is actually pretty good, and everything's been working fine. Like, they try to make everything run smoothly time. Yeah. It rarely crashes, if at all.
I mean, it crashes at the same rate that Xbox does, which is DDoSers and hackers.
Yeah.
Which usually happens on Christmas Day, because, hey, fuck your happiness and your new toys that you just got. Wait 2 days to play it.
That's why Nintendo's awesome. You don't have to worry about that.
They also got DDoS on Christmas Day last year.
Did they?
Yeah. Christmas Day, any Wii U or like online services on Wii U were unavailable because Nintendo's network was down. I couldn't play Smash Bros. Online with anyone.
They were probably just in maintenance, you know that, right?
Really?
They do that.
You realize that every Christmas Day, all major gaming platforms get just slowed down to hell because all hacker groups basically go, hey, fuck your happiness, we're going to bring down these services. And it happens every single year. And every single year, there's always a news report by someone that Xbox Live, PSN, Nintendo, and I don't think Steam's ever gone down. Maybe it has, and I just haven't paid attention. But they always go down every Christmas morning. And Nintendo is not exempt from it. And if you're doing maintenance on Christmas Day, you have some kind of scheduling error in your head, because that is kind of fucked up. That's more than a little bit fucked up.
Oh, come on, isn't it like you're going to use Nintendo services online?
Let's say I got Splatoon for Christmas.
Then you're screwed.
Exactly. Anyway, that's that done, I guess. Thanks for watching.
That's it, yep.
Like, subscribe, do that usual. Hey, we got a nice little lens flare right there. Yeah, that.
Directed by J.J. Abrams.
Where is that coming from? I can't figure that out.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and I didn't too. PlayStation is going to be playable on PCs.
Oh, yeah, that's right. They're coming out with,
yeah, with the PS3 games. Not like new PS4 games, but PS3 games.
PS3 games are getting ported to PC, which is awesome, because maybe now people will realize never mind, I can't make that joke because people will think I'm serious. PC Master Race. Because Xbox was already doing that, where the, what was it, the Windows 10?
Windows 10, yeah.
Like, all one big platform, basically. So, you know.
So, Record is going to be the first one to come out like that, where you can play Record, you can buy Record for PC or Xbox One, and you can play them on the other one. On
both, yeah. I'm assuming that's if you get the digital one, right? That's probably not going to be if you get the physical media.
I don't know, but it downloads everything, right? So, like,
I mean, yeah, but
it's connected to your user.
Basically.
So, I feel like if you buy it, you can.
Yeah.
But, yeah, now PC can play anything.
I was going to talk about this today. We're going a little bit long. We should probably wrap this up, but there was a Russian development group, I don't know what they're called, that were making Halo for PC. They recently got shut down by Microsoft. So, anyone that was hoping to play Halo on PC, sorry, but get an Xbox. There's no other way to do it anymore.
You do realize eventually Microsoft's going to end up
releasing Halo PC. But, like, they were almost done. They had a working demo that played, like, Halo 3 multiplayer. They were really close to finishing it, and now they're shut down.
I mean, here's what's going to happen. Like, the next Halo game is going to come out for PC.
I mean, I hope so.
I mean, but they are, and there's an
initiative. Right now, there's no way to play Halo on PC, and this close to getting Halo on PC. Of course, it's Russian, so they're still going to do it, and they're just not going to release it to the US. But that kind of sucks, because, you know, it would have been great to play Halo with my friends that don't have Xboxes, which is most of them because they're smart, and I'm not, because I'm a Halo fanboy. Halo was the only reason I got Xbox One. Fun.
But... yeah, I mean, I'm just waiting for what's the game? The Last of Us to come out on PC.
Oh.
Because I will actually get that.
I don't think I ever played The Last of Us, and I have a PlayStation 3.
I mean, because I hear the game is just fantastic, so I just want to try it out.
I should probably get The Last of Us. I should play through that. I have a PS3, I just don't think I ever picked up The Last of Us.
Like, eventually, I'm going to start playing more Xbox and PlayStation games on my Mac.
Mac's not giving PC. Anyway, that's it from us. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, blah, blah, blah. Usual YouTube spiel. And we'll see you next time. Bye.
Yeah, bye.